One of my favorite nails to do and wear are French white colors. Black, one of my favorite, but black is very hard to do, especially in acrylic. But I'm gonna make it easy today with tips. Let's get started. I want to thank Exclusive Nail Couture for sponsoring this video and sending me these black French tips. Two different sizes, extra long and long, in coffin and stiletto. I think I'm going to pick the stiletto. Now, why I like these is because when you do black French, working with acrylic powder or the poly gel, hydrogel, or gel sculpting, it actually takes a little while, but these are super, super fast and way easier to do because sculpting French is very time consuming and it takes a lot of skill to get it right. With these, you don't really need a ton of skill and you don't need a lot of time. You just need the right procedures. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So I took everything off of this hand, so they're ready to go, but I do have one nail left to buff and that's what I want to show you. So it's really the step-by-step procedures and doing the right procedures and the right curing times, which makes this last, and using the right products. So I'm going to buff up each and every nail, which I've pretty much done for each and every finger, but I'll just do one more. So I'm just going to do my ring finger here. And I'm just going to make sure I buff up every single little spot on my nail. Just as a little buffing tip, no matter what you're applying to your nail, make sure every little shiny area must be buffed. That is like the number one rule for any type of adhesion. I use the corner of a file here to get into the very, very fine, fine corners. Oh, also too, if you're removing any product, make sure, you can knead it a little bit down the center, but make sure the sides and the cuticle area are completely removed of product because you want the tip to sit down inside on your natural nail. You don't want it to sit on top of your nail and then top of product, then the tip. It makes it sit too high. So do make sure you get it off all of the sides. You can leave a strip down the middle, that will be okay, but it's really gotta come off the sides. I have two cats in this room rummaging around and all my nail products. We don't know where they are. We can just hear them. Actually, I think one is just sleeping in the corner, right? Aww. It's Butternut.
Yeah, you can only see her back half.
Yeah.
Cute face.
She is so cute. Okay. Before we were shooting, getting ready for the video, she kept sitting in Karen Mann's chair and he kept having to remove her so we can get started. And Gigi is a little bit more active. She's rummaging around in all my stuff. Okay, so yeah, I've got them all done here and I'm just gonna make sure there's no dust. As a general rule, product does not like dust. Okay, now for the first step, we wanna prep and we want to prime. These are going to be Exclusive Nail Couture's Prep and Prime. So I'm going to put on the prep. Prep is like a cleanser. You can put that everywhere. And then I'm going to put the primer on. Usually when I put the primer on, you start with a bigger finger and it's really just on the natural nail area. You don't have to do it on the acrylic areas. And then the thumb. I think I have a little more product on the edge of that one. I've been doing nails for 35 now, right, cameraman?
Yeah, I think that's right, yeah.
My goodness. That's a long time. I started when I was 10. Okay, so even I, after 35 years, I have to really remember what the steps are and the curing times. And that really is the procedure with anything that you're doing. If something's not working, it's going to be maybe that you didn't cure it properly or in the right lamp or long enough or those kinds of things. But I will say when I do this, I'm just doing it myself, right? And that's why I want to give you the tips to be able to do this yourself using E-Nail Couture's full hand lamp. Because I find holding it with a little lamp that this company recommends, you can use a little lamp. For me, I just find that too awkward. I like to hold it and then nuke it. This is the press-on gel. So I've got two different colors. One is clear and one is a pink. Exclusive Nail Couture recommends using the pink. You can use the clear, but I'm going to use the pink. And this is actually quite a simple step. It's quite pretty, actually. I quite like this. I'm just literally going to paint a thin layer of this gel on. This is my adhesion layer to make my tip stick. Paint this on nice and thin, just like a nice thin coat of polish. Like the brush, it fits nicely in there. Sometimes you can get a good product, but if you don't get a good brush, it's so frustrating if you can't get your product on. It's a pretty color. It's very natural looking. Okay, and this company recommends you hold it upside down for about, well, anywhere between 10 to 15, 20, 30 seconds, he says. And then we're going to put it under the lamp and we're going to cure it for 30 seconds. I got a 30 second thing. Put it on there. My nail beds are a bit on the thinner side. So if you have this problem where it burns a little bit, creep into it. Like slowly just creep into the light. And what it's doing is actually curing a little bit slower. So it doesn't like cure right away and burn your finger. Because I do have that problem sometimes. Add a few seconds of cure time if you want to creep your hand in. Now there is a button on this. It's like for 99 seconds, but it's much lower light and slower. So that for someone like me, it's perfect for, and you can put your hand all the way in. So there's two ways of doing it if you don't have that button to go a little bit slower. It's a really great feature. I personally love it because that's one of the reasons why I did not like gel in the beginning, because it would burn. And it makes it feel like it's the fault of the product, but it's actually just thinner nail beds, right? So you want to make sure that you're kind of creeping into that light. I'll just leave it in a little longer because I creeped in. Okay, so these are already pre-etched for you on the inside. So that's one less step you don't have to do. That makes it a little bit quicker. So the question is, okay, I don't really want the coffin. Okay, so here's the stiletto sizes, but I don't think I want them too long, although they do look nice. But I think I'm going to go for more of a, I'm kind of feeling a little bit shorter lately, even though these ones are kind of longish. Okay, so now I want to size some up. And I'm going to try to make this work with the sizes because I want to do these quick. I don't want to have to fuss around with them too much. That's why I'm doing these kinds of nails. I don't really want to fuss too much with the shape. So let's see if I can just find the ones that I'm happy with without doing any shaping to them. Okay. I've always had luck with the thumbs, I think. Ooh. That fits nice. Ooh. That's very nice. Let's try one size a bit bigger. That's not bad. I like the shape. See the shape of the cuticle on this one? That really fits my finger nice. I think that's actually pretty good. I think I'm going to go with this one. So these particular tips are meant to have a look of an extended French line, smile line. And when you do an extended French, usually you build it, when you're building it with acrylic or hydrogel or gel, you extend the nail plate with a color, more solid color, and then you extend the smile line of the black or the white or the color, whatever you're doing, out a little bit further than what your natural nail plate is. These tips are designed the same way. They actually extend the black to make it look more longer and more elegant. It's actually very pretty, and I love the look. I've been doing that for years. But they built it into the tip. But it's not completely opaque. If you look at that tip and look at my finger, you can see if I put that tip now over top of my finger, can you see that underneath there where you can really see? I'll turn the light on. Maybe you can see it really clear. Yeah, see that? Do you see that? That see-throughness? I hate that. But when you're sculpting and building it, you can build it more opaque. But these are a little bit more see-through, which is nice because you're seeing the nail underneath. But your nail's not going to be long like that because we're extending the nail plate. So Nail Grfx has solved that problem. Max has a gel that is more opaque. So normally we would put the product here. You can see the color of it? It's very strong. It's kind of nice having this little spout here to pull it out there like that. And you can use the tip right here, which is quite an advantage. The trick is you don't want to get too much because you don't want it to spill around on the sides and stuff, right? But as you keep doing this, you'll get better at it. I know how the light's coming through there, so I'm going to cover that I'm just going to do it with the nozzle here. I'm hoping that that is going to be an ample amount of product by the time I squeeze it onto my finger. Now I'm going to learn. This is an experience. I'm going to have to learn how much product I need to put in there so it fills all the way out. So I'm going to put it. Actually, Max does it where he kind of puts it here and then he slides it up. You could do that, I guess. I don't know if I'm going to like that as much. And then I'm just gently pressing it down. But don't press it too far. That's a mistake I made with one of my fingers last time. I am going to hold it here like this. I am going to have a brush ready. So if I have any spillage, I can take it out before I nuke it. I'm just, ooh, look at that. Extra product in there. Yuck. So what I'm going to try to do, I'm going to hold it on the table just gently so I don't push it. I'm going to just pull it right out. Now, if you didn't like that and you wanted to get rid of that, you could simply do it again. Pull it off and get another tip and do it again. But I think I can salvage this. I think I don't have to do that. It's on there pretty good. I just want to make sure I don't have any gel coming through on the other side. I don't want to see that. I'll have to shake that a little bit. I think that's good. Okay, I'm just going to give it 10 seconds. He just said do a 10-second nuke and then it'll be secured in place and you can go ahead and do the other one. And I do advise that because if you bump it, you're not going to make that movie or dinner. Okay. One done. Okay. So I do see a little gap in there. That's what he said. The little nozzle. He was telling me about that before. So maybe I didn't have to take any away. Maybe I did have the right amount. You can just fill a little bit in there. You know, Max mentioned it and I never experienced it before. So I didn't know 100% what he was talking about, but I'm glad I did hear that. Because now I know what he was talking about. Now maybe I'll just give that a little nuke so I don't have to worry about that. Okay, now I can go on to the other fingers. And then when I secure them all with that 10 second cure, I can go ahead and nuke them all at once. It's pretty quick actually. Look at that, it's done. So if you do get any product on your skin, wipe it away as quick as you can. I find it very effective with a clean, dry brush. If you're going to get it wet, make sure it's wet with like alcohol, I find is the best. Like get the alcohol on your brush and then clean it, dry it, and then clean it and swipe it away. If you do not clean it away, it will nuke to your finger. And again, I'm going to do that 10 seconds. I didn't need much. The better you get at this, the less product you'll get on your finger. And I do advise you really don't want to get product on your finger. If you're doing these all the time, especially you're getting product on your finger constantly, you want to try not to do that's a good fit. You can see the difference, eh? When you do the pink all the way up, it's opaque right to the very end where the black starts. If you don't put it on there, you can see how you can see the light through. That's what the difference is. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and put the other two on. Getting the hang of it. Looks like there's no overspillage on this one at all. Check right here. Nope. I'm getting better. Okay, let's give it 10 seconds. Now the next finger's a bit bigger, so I need a little bit more, but just a tiny bit more. That was not a bad fit. I mean, they're not going to fit perfect because they're not custom designed. I mean, I could shape them and stuff, but I'm trying to do this quick, right? I mean, you can get really crazy and really custom them, and that's fine. But if you just want this for it, get them on and quick so you can get out the door, you want to make it fit. You want to make it work. Maybe I should do one custom just so you know what it looks like. That one fit pretty good. I mean, my cuticles are much more oval. And these are a little bit more square, and I'll custom the next one to show you how you can do that. That one fit really good, and you just put a little bit of pressure. I didn't need much, and I actually put the right amount of product. It's not spilling out, So I am just getting the hang of it. So 10 seconds just to flash cure it so it doesn't bump out of place. And then I'll do the minute for the whole thing. Okay, so let me just custom one so I can show you. If you want to do that, you could do that. Okay, that's not a bad fit at all. It's quite a bit wider than my cuticle is. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's just a different look. But if I wanted to custom fit it, then I would just take a file and I would just try to shape it so that it would fit into my natural nail a bit better. My cuticle area is just a little bit more round than it is this square. Just a few little tweaks here and there might do it. Wipe away the dust and then just sort of place it in there and see if it looks better. Okay, so I'm gonna check both sides. That's actually a really good fit. And yeah, it fits my cuticle a little bit better. I could go even a little rounder. It just depends on how picky you get and how much time you might have or patience. Okay, now I'm gonna get my smooth file and just smooth that out one little bit more. Just make sure that's nice and smooth. Okay, remove the dust. It's nice, it's different, it's unusual. Anybody know where that's from? Okay, and then I'm going to add my pink gel. So I'm not really bulking it out too much. I'm just sort of filling in the nail bed area. And that seems to be the right amount that I need to do the build, you might say. Okay, I'm gonna slide it up into the cuticle area a little bit there. Gently press it down, just gently. Oh, it's a little bit crooked. It's easy to make it crooked, so do check that. Oh yeah, I checked the other ones. I kind of did and kind of didn't. Yeah, they're not bad. Pretty good, actually. So just check that, make sure it's not crooked. Now, here's where the tip can be a little bit of a problem. My fingers are quite curved this way. Not a ton, but just enough. That the tips are a little bit more flat. So it either fits in the cuticle and it sticks up higher this way a little bit, or I make it bend down to where my natural nail would flow a bit and the cuticle's gonna stick up. So there's a little bit of a sacrifice you have to make for these kinds of tips. It's not gonna fit everybody absolutely perfectly because it is a pre-shaped tip. But that's not bad. I've sort of compromised between the two and that's not bad.
I noticed there's some smudge.
Oh, it's not the black where it's kind of cloudy a little bit. It's not as shiny. Mm-hmm.
Is that because you touched it with gel?
Yeah, it must have been, yeah.
Oh, so you got to be careful.
I could take it off and do it again if I'm not going to top coat them, but I'm going to top coat them, I think. I am. I want to top coat them because see the little tips when you get these things, they can be attached to these, or if you're taking it off, they will have a little thing at the top, right? Right there. See that? Is that little divot?
Yeah.
That's when it was attached to this thing at some point. So we do want to file that off. So I'm just going to check and make sure this is good. But if I'm not going to put a top coat, I would take that off and do it again. But it is a bit smudgy there. I didn't get any product on the side. That's pretty good. And again, make sure that it's straight. Yeah. Make sure the cuticle's flush. As flush as I can get it, right? Because remember, my finger's a bit more curvy. Okay, I'm going to nuke it for 60 seconds. And that is your full and final cure for 60 seconds. Okay, there we have it. We did it. So you could put a top coat on and off you go. And you're going to have some nice nails. But if you want to be a little bit pickier, you can just take a little pass at the cuticle area and the free edge. Remember that little thing there? If that bugs you? I mean, it's not a huge flaw, but if you're picky and you can notice that, that might bug you.
Oh, it'd bug you. I see it.
It would bug you because you're extra picky. And I see some things like this black goes down way further than on this side. Do you see that?
Right. I'm curious when you file, if you take the black right off and you're going to have to put
Yes, the black would come off. Well, let's try it. Look, I'll just grab a tip here. And I guess I'm having a little trouble picking them up. Okay, so if I file these. Okay, yeah, look at that. It's coming right off there. So yeah, there it's painted on top. It's not black all the way through, right? So when you're filing these, be careful that you don't take the paint off because then you have to take it off and you don't want to do that. But with this little divot on the end, we want that smooth. So make sure when you're filing it, you're just filing the very end and making it nice and smooth and you're not filing the top part, at least with a coarse file. Okay, so I'm just getting rid of those things where they were joined on that tip. Thank you. Not much. Be very careful. Okay, so now I have a question. I was going to buff them a little, but let me check something. If I buff it a little bit with this buffer, is it going to remove it? No, looks like it'll be okay. But how much can I do it before? Yeah, not much. And then you can start to take it off, right? So the, even this soft buffer could take some of the black off. So I don't want to do that. Okay, so I'm going to look at the cuticles now. I'm going to be a little bit pickier. And I could go around the cuticle, but don't hit the black part because it's not going to like it. You could do this. Just go around the cuticle a little bit. But I mean, that's getting kind of picky. If you want to do that, you can do that. I personally like the look because it separates the cuticle from the tip. It just makes it a little bit more like a separation, and that looks more natural. Woo! The cat just climbed up on the back of your chair.
Yep. Oh, she's thinking of going for my cables.
Oh! Watch a camera go down. Mm-hmm. Okay, so yeah, you can see that cuticle area looks a little bit better when you do that. I kind of like that. Just gives a little bit of a separation, looks a little bit more natural if you have the time to do that. You don't have to do it, it's just if you want to. Okay, so for that one that got a little cloudy, I'm just gonna buff it ever so slightly. Okay, so I got rid of that kind of buffed mark. I didn't file any of the gel off. Now I'm going to use Wonder Gel because it's a little bit thicker, and Max said you can sort of settle into the cuticle area if it's a little bit of a demarcation, or if it's a little bit thicker, you can sort of fill it in a little bit, or if you filed away a little bit too much, it just sort of fills it in a little bit. It helps you out. So we can file away the cuticle area, but you don't have to buff the whole thing. Generally, we do that with top coat, but you don't have to with these. So dust free. Get rid of all that dust. Okay, so it just depends on how picky you want to get with the cuticle. You do whatever that you have time for or you have the patience for. Depends on how quick you want these on. Now I'm top coating them with the Wonder Gel. Give this another 60-second nuke, and we can look at the reveal. I'll put some oil on the cuticle, and then we can look at the reveal pictures. I want to thank Exclusive Nail Couture for sponsoring this video. I want to show you the 5XL tips that video I did a few weeks ago. These are the longest nails I ever worn, and I actually wore them for 3 weeks. Can you guys believe it? They're absolutely gorgeous. The full cover tips, check it out.